Philippine President Marcos Jr. vows to push back against China if it ignores Philippine sovereignty. He also dismissed allegations that Philippine foreign policy is dictated by the U.S. The president spoke in Melbourne, where Pia Gutierrez filed this report.
Despite China's increasing aggressiveness in the South China Sea, the Philippines will continue the path of dialogue and diplomacy to address tensions. That statement made by President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. in his speech at the Lowy Institute here in Melbourne, Australia. He says government will continue to engage with China and make bilateral mechanisms work to peacefully manage territorial disputes. The Philippine leader, however, clarifies that the Philippines will continue to push back against actions that threaten its territorial integrity.
Our independent foreign policy compels us to cooperate with them on matters where our interests align, to respectfully disagree on areas where our views differ, and to push back when our sworn principles, such as our sovereignty, our sovereign rights, and our jurisdiction in the West Philippine Sea are questioned or ignored.
The president called out China's provocative, unilateral, and illegal actions, which he says continue to infringe upon the country's integrity and obstruct peace in the region. Foreign Affairs Secretary Enrique Manalo echoed the president's statements in another forum here in Melbourne as part of the ongoing ASEAN-Australia summit, saying that while the Philippines is committed to the peaceful resolution of disputes, China should stop actions that harass the Philippines.
Highlighting or putting in the media incidents in the South China Sea is precisely a part of our democracy, and it's merely trying to inform the people of what's going on. Some countries, or one country at least, has had some difficulty with that, but our simple explanation is if you would stop harassing us and perhaps performing other actions, there wouldn't be any news to report.
As in 1940. The president, meanwhile, called out those who framed the South China Sea issue simply on the rivalry between the United States and China, saying these notions undermine the legitimate rights and interests of other countries like the Philippines.
There is a narrative out there that is going around that we are at the beck and call, practically, of the United States when it comes to these foreign policy decisions, especially surrounding the South China Sea. But let me make it very, very clear. The Philippines acts for its own interests. And the decisions that we make when it comes to foreign policy are decisions that we make because we believe and are convinced and know that it is in the national interest.
The South China Sea issue also expected to be on top of the agenda of Southeast Asian and Australian leaders as they meet here in Melbourne this week for the ASEAN-Australia Special Summit. Meanwhile, on Monday, President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. met with the Cambodian Prime Minister to talk about the possible strengthening of defense ties between both countries, as well as on tourism and in trade. Also at the sidelines of the summit, the Philippine leader meanwhile invited Australian businessmen to invest in the Philippines during the Philippine Business Forum Monday at the sidelines of the summit. 14 deals worth a total $1.53 billion in Australian investments were also signed during the president's visit. Pia Gutierrez, ABS-CBN News.